Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the answer video of the drag and drop exercise of 3.1. In this exercise, the question was what the relationship between the form drag and the friction drag is for these four drawn objects in a flow. The first one, the small plate, is a thin plate parallel to the flow. The second one would be a wing profile. It's like the wings you have on a plane. Third one would be, and don't mind my drawing, a perfect sphere. And the last one would be a plate perpendicular to the flow. So how we would solve this problem is, first of all, we would draw the streamlines. And a streamline is, is the flow that a water molecule would take if it were actually in the flow passing the object. So for the thin flat plate, the trick is to see it as a really thin plate. So the flow would move as such. There's almost no way or no flow line where the flow has to really bend itself around the object. So the only real drag force here is along the skin or along the surface of the object. And we as physicists, we like to simplify things. And we simplify this very thin plate by saying that it is infinitely thin and that there is in fact no flow that has to move away to go around this. So we say, in a perfect case, in a physics case, there is 0% form drag and there is 100% friction drag. So there is no flow that has to move away. So there is, at this point, there is no pressure exerted. There is no form drag. And there is, so there must be 100% friction drag. For the wing profile, it is slightly thicker, so we have a few flow lines that have to go around the object, around the stagnation point, as aerospace students really like to call it. It's not very well visible. This means that there is, in this case, two types of drag. There is a little bit here, because the flow has to move up, a little bit down, it has to move around the object, and there is a lot of skin, a lot of surface area that touches. So over here we have a friction drag, a skin friction. Because there is so little friction, so little form drag, excuse me, and so much friction, there is a lot of surface area, and there is not much that the flow lines have to move to get around it. That's the function of the wing. There is about, say, 10% form drag and about 90% friction drag. These are good estimations for it. So for the perfect sphere, if we draw the lines, we will see that they have to move out of the way quite a lot. If they start from this point over here. Oh, that's not even very well visible. This means that there is again two types of drag. The first one being the form drag. There has to be a lot of movement from these from the flow lines to go around the object. It's a big bulky object. The flow is not passing very well, and then there is a little bit of skin in contact with the flow, a little bit of surface area. So we like to estimate this by about 90% form drag, because there is a big area that it has to move, and about 10% friction drag. It's not much surface area. There's not that much surface area. For the last case, it is a plate perpendicular to the flow. So if we would draw the lines, the flow lines, holy moly, do they have to move. It is, they have to go out of their way a lot. So what you get is that over here, the flow really has to go out of its way, out of its zone to move around the object and to make the streamlines more accurate. If there is if it does that big, there's going to be vortices here, and there's going to be all sorts of complicated flow phenomena. Well, we're not going to focus that right now. We want to know the relationship between the form drag and the friction drag. So if we look at the friction at the area, there's only these two small areas that create a friction drag. And again, here we're being physicists and we're saying that the plate is infinitely small, so that this area and this area approaches zero. So it's very, very thin. Then we see that only the flow has to move out of its way, and that there is almost none. So as physicists, we say there's no friction drag. So for this case, we would say it is 100% form drag and 0% friction drag. I hope it has become a little bit more clear for you if this was unclear for you. If you have any questions, feel free to contact anyone on the discussion forum, because I'm sure they're quite willing to help.